It's the best of You've Been Framed. And in tonight's top countdown, Wedded Blitz. Animal Magic. And Holiday Tragic. It's the best of the best. And we're in the workplace. That poor woman's been waiting for years for her new balcony. Oops, the nail that broke the balcony's back. Ah, the High Street Electrical Shop. The expertise is staggering. Oops! All the rest of the tellies are on the blink now.
That's Claire's team just in the lead.
To think you rely on this bunch when your house is on fire.
Come on, catch up!
Oh, just get back to the snooker, would you? It's a wonder the whole country isn't ablaze. Laurel and Hardy didn't die. They came back as these two. That's another fine mess you've gotten me into. Why can't you do something to help me? And finally, where do you keep your doors? I tend to keep mine in the walls, as opposed to the floors. And there's a very good reason for that. Wow! And that's it. It's to stop big women falling through them. Time to take a ride with the best of your Clips on Wheels. Of the weddings. Here goes the hat. There goes the mum-in-law. Off down Coronation Street. Where's that hat gone? Oh, there it is. I like the big orange bridal coach, don't you? Give it up, love. You're late. Oh. haunting melody, which is, sure I know that one. Never gonna give you up, never gonna put you down, never gonna run around. Oh, forget it. Thank heavens the riflemen have turned up. Nothing worse at a wedding than low-flying trees, is there? Gosh, look at that big orange arm. This is no time to practice your Joe Pasquale impression.
For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health.
Cheer up, mate. Her other arm's pink.
Longer. It's safe with one. Can you raise your glasses and a toast to the barmaids?
Bridesmaids, even one. The barmaids? Please take your glasses back to the bridesmaids. Where's this held? A sports hall? Oops! 30 light bulbs ruined. Still to come on the best of Framed. Mum's in trouble. Babes in arms. And Granny goes wild. See you very soon. Welcome back to the very best of You've Been Framed. Now it's the classic dad clips. And why do some dads insist on buying presents for their kids that truthfully they want themselves? If you had a spike on the end of that, you could pick up that litter. Oops. He knocked over the tiny tree. Someone give him a hand. You know what, everyone? Forget trying to climb up the hill. Let's just go body surfing instead. Hey! Ah, the pleasures of the long, thin garden.
Thank you.
Oops! He's done nearly £3 worth of damage there. Oh dear, Teddy's fallen in the water. And it's Dad to the rescue. By holding onto a leaf, he's trying to tickle it to the water's edge. He falls in and he doesn't bother to retrieve the teddy. Get back in there. Yeah, swings in your own garden. They're never as good as the ones at the park, are they? Best get rid of it. Backward cycling on a child's bike. Great fun. That table there, is it a fold-down one? It is now. Don't worry, it's not a real rhino. There's no way it could possibly harm anyone. Attacked by a plastic rhino. Now for the mums. Well, that's one way of washing his pants. Your turn, Mum. That's not a rocking chair. That is, in fact, a highly elaborate belt.
Leo! Mom!
Oh, dear. He's stuck. That's it, Mum. Show him how it's done. Ah, the English at play. It's overcast, chilly, it's a back garden. But the fun you can have with a polythene sheet and a slide. That's why everyone's moving to Spain. Oh, look, it's Jill. Nice idea to get the garden slabbed over. What do you do? Hoover it. Nice one, Jill.
Don't say that!
It's the best of your golfing clips now. Four!
Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. That's when the caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say. Back down the fairway, it went straight down the fairway. And it started to slice just a smidge off line. It headed for two, but it bounced off nine. My caddy said, as long as you're still in the state, you're okay. As it went straight down the middle, by the way. The sun was ever brighter, the green were.
Ever tried this? Just speaking in vowels for a whole day?
Hey, it's very fun. It's very fun.
What was all that about? Yes, we're hitting the stage, and here we have the amazing Transo and Javine doing two acts at once. First, hypnosis, and the second, as a sideline, demonstrating the Black & Decker multi-purpose workmate. Great for DIY. Terrible for levitation. Whoops. They charge to watch this particular show. I want my money back. That's it, Vicar. Camera, action, lights. Oh, look, it's Jesus. Oh, charming, that is. Jesus Christ, super pants. Look at this bloke. Now, that's what I call acting. It's behind you. And just look at his improvisational skills. He just carries on as if nothing's happened. Sorry about the bleached-out nature of this clip. The camera can only cope with so many bald heads. But listen to him go. And now, watch him go. Even years ago, before Amarillo, little Peter Kay was used to finishing the whole song. Let him sing a rainbow. Start again? We'll be here all night. Holiday time now, and I think I'm spotting a flaw in this whole girl's swimwear stroke rock climbing outfit. Oops. Going gondola. What a spoil sport that Alsatian is. Now that's just naughty. It's midday at Club Sangria, and Rob's finally decided to show the ladies what they've been missing. Go on, Rob. Oh, and he was doing so well. An ordinary June day in Torquay, and coconut-addicted vandals bring down another innocent tree. It was bounty happen. Get it? Bounty. Oh, forget it. Relaxing in a rock pool with a can of beer. He's got to be Australian, hasn't he? But there's not an over-the-counter cream on earth that'll get rid of this. Oh, I can feel that.
Funny.
It is actually. Time for your babies. And at a christening, you don't have to bring your own water. Dirty boy. Here's the very first jet-propelled baby. And they're off. Everybody now. Ah, great fun. See, it's very difficult to chew, isn't it, when you're a baby? What he needs is some teeth. There they are, look. This is an unusual attachment for a vacuum cleaner. Perhaps you use it to get under tables and pick up old bits of food. They're good at that. No, put him back on the vacuum cleaner. Don't you hate it when your cleaner brings a baby to work? Yes, there's plenty to do upstairs if you've done downstairs. Oh, it's freezing, doesn't it? What's this? China bowl and a frog. Oh, there's a frog on my face. That's it. Just let the frog climb over your baby's face. Here's where they got the idea for that car advert. Green fingers. Not this lot. Part three, fun with Grandad. Don't do it yourself. And freaky dancing, all after the break. Welcome back to the best of You've Been Framed. Some people have aphids in their bushes. This chap has an infestation of grannies. She just lurches from bush to bush, destroying them wherever she goes. The Bush Killer. You guessed our theme, it's grannies. This lot are at the hugely unattended Duncan Goodhue Museum, celebrating the life and work of our greatest bald swimmer. But you know the problem these days. A total lack of respect. Here we are, back at the garden party at Sandringham. Her Majesty is holding another one of her drink all you can for a tenner garden parties.
Happy birthday, big guy.
On the subject of grandchildren, they are a precious, unique gift, aren't they?
Nicholas.
Yeah. What's his name? Where am I? Who's the Prime Minister? I know what you're thinking, but it's okay. She's got her glasses on upside down too, so it cancels it out. And the prerogative of the old make a mistake, blame someone else.
Hello, what's her name?
Susan.
Judith.
Susan. Susan.
Julie.
Susan.
Julie. Is that her first name?
Susan.
Susan. You want to learn to speak proper English? Susan.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't form your words properly, do you? It's the talking slang, sure. Isn't it?
Anyway, this is my number.
You're scooting. Hello, Susan.
Move over, Granny. Here's Granddad. Oh, dear, my trousers appear to have fallen down. I do apologize. Just pull them up and get on with it.
That's a prima. And what's that one?
Okay.
And what's that one then?
Whistling.
A penguin. Whistling. And what's that
one? A muskrat.
Oh, that's a difficult one.
Dear, oh dear. Someone open a window. And that's just the ones we can hear. It's the wrap party for the last of the summer wine. They write themselves, those shows. David Hasselhoff in his twilight years. Still driving the same computer car from Knight Rider, but they've both fallen out quite badly.
I never liked you, David.
The trouble with age is that after putting in a tiny bit of effort, you just have to go and have a nice lie down. There's the effort. And now the lie down. Here we go. Yeah, it's for cutting grass. Not pruning trees. Yeah, it's pretty funny this, isn't it? Until you find out that he's actually dead.
Here is our guest of honor. We're celebrating Joe's 90th birthday today.
Yep, it's Joe's 90th birthday today, but an old dog can learn new tricks. Best acting on TV since Crossroads. It's that white plastic garden chair again. Hey! Mission accomplished. It's monkey fun now.
Here we come. Up on the screen. Get funny as works from everyone we meet.
Hey, we're the monkeys. We tell the monkey around. We're too busy singing. Put anybody down.
To do time to get restless. There's always something new.
Hey, hey, we're the monkeys. People say we monkey around. We're too busy singing to put anybody down. We're just trying to be friendly. Come and watch us sing and play. We're the young generation. We've got something to say. Shoulder, cause we're standing there.
Hey, hey, we're the monkeys. People say we monkey around. We're too busy singing to put anybody down.
Some DIY disasters now for you. Not counting that blouse, Jeans decided to have a go at putting up a shelf. But when things go wrong, she discovers a new talent. She can sing in Chinese. Lift me up. I see. And where were you planning to put the stairs?
That fireplace is going to be abolished.
Oh, I see, just there, yes. Yes, I can see how that might work. Language, please. Someone call Nick Knowles. It's a DIY SOS. Nice to spend a quiet afternoon just scraping. That's a hell of a pigeon they've got upstairs. Woo-hoo. You've probably got a favourite out of these two sheds. I like the green one myself. Don't get me wrong, the brown one's nice. I think I prefer the brown one. If I had to choose the brown one, yes. Three blokes working next door and two desperate housewives up in the bedroom filming every moment for later. Women, eh? Ooh. He's okay, he's okay. His hair has broken his fall. Right, wee laddie. We've given you the crucial job of fitting the sink. It's very simple. It fits in that hole. You would have to have laid a very long pipe to reach it, though, wouldn't you? It's time for the kids. This boy's playing in an area where ladders grow wild. There's one, look. But he was never taught the nursery rhyme about Dr. Foster going to Gloucester in a shower of rain. He stepped in a puddle right up to his middle. Ooh. And never went there again. He's got a pocket full of water, look. At least he's got something out of it. What did you get for Christmas?
A Barbie set.
A Barbie set, yes. But the big question is, do you like it?
No, but that's not the one that I wanted, but I'll do it.
Look, poor kid. His bedroom consists of some rubble, one football, and Dad's 30-year-old lawnmower. And that's broken.
Yes,
the Easter Bunny's been and dropped some rabbit eggs all over the garden.
What kind of fish you have, my dear?
Oh, look, cash. I've found a whole cache of them here. Fancy that. Who's had my eggs? They haven't had any film work for a while, so Eeyore and Tigger have gone into waitressing.
Are you going to try when they come over here? Okay.
Yeah, giant donkey standing on its back legs, might scare even me.
What number do you want, David?
Amazing to think that in these days of computer consoles, a game involving catching a small plastic mouse by dropping a ball down some stairs and releasing a high diver can still provoke the kind of reaction some kids get from Grand Theft Auto. It's Mousetrap.
Here's the winner.
With a bit of buckaroo thrown in. Dancing disasters now, and here's why you're not allowed to wear dark-soled shoes in a sports hall. Ooh. Ah, look, Peter Stringfellow's cleaners have turned up. Ever get the feeling that the chief cheerleader's brother has seen this routine one too many times? I'm sorry, but if your first dance as a married couple is to Glenn Medeiros, you deserve everything you get. I mean Glenn Medeiros. Look at that parquet flooring there. Beautiful. Now a great brother and sister dance come martial arts routine. Oh, right under the chin. I did that once. I couldn't eat crisps for a week. This old gent looks like a barrel of fun, but how can he top the fez? Oh! Yeah, all right. Just pull him up and get back to the home. Music now. Tune in, load up. It's the best of the worst weather.
Vincent! It's a barbecue, all right. It's a barbecue.
The weather is frightening. Thunder and lightning seem to be having their way. But as far as I'm concerned, it's a lovely day. The turn in the weather will keep us together. So I can honestly say that as far as I'm concerned, it's a lovely day. And everything's okay. It's a lovely day to be caught in the rain. You were going on your way. Now you've got to remain. Just as you were going, leaving me all at sea. The clouds broke. They broke and oh, what a break for me. I can see the sun up high, though we're caught in the storm. And I can see where you and I could be cozy and warm. Now let the rain hit a cat, because it really doesn't matter if the skies are gray. Just as long as I can be with you, it's a lovely day.
And there's even more to come, including feline foul-ups, disappearing dogs, and birthday blues. Back soon. Welcome back to the best of You've Been Framed. Something for you cat lovers now. Why do we love them? Because they're lazy. Dear Harry, I've never seen a kitten rev up. Do you have a clip that could help me? I certainly do. Here's the kitten. Here's the revving up. Another classic, the harmonic cat. Perhaps he's been eating too many mouse organs. Get it? Mouse organs. Oh, what's the point?
Say mama.
Mama. Now say cat food. Fed up with your cat pestering the fish, buy some piranhas. This, of course, is how Milli Vanilli started out. Remember them kids? No, me neither. This is what I like to see, a vocal supporter of You've Been Framed. And now I will wave my magic wand and make Shep disappear. Oh, don't spoil it, Shep.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it.
What if you're happy but you don't know it? What do you do then? A bedtime story has the same effect, whatever your species. Oh, I'm beginning to nod off myself here. Would someone wake me up at the break?
Maggie's going to get the paper.
That's it, Maggie. Go on, Maggie. Go and get the paper.
Fetch it up, Maggie. Fetch it up. Fetch it up. Come, Maggie.
Come on, Maggie. Bring it back.
Good girl. Come on, Maggie. Come, Maggie.
That's it, Maggie.
Come, Maggie. Maggie, come.
Maggie.
Maggie, come.
I hope you're not...
Come on. Come. Maggie, come.
Maggie, just hand it over.
Don't pee on it.
Oh. Dirty Maggie. Dirty girl. If you're celebrating today, this one's for you. If you're not, it's still for you.
Happy birthday to you.
That's your lot for this special, but you've seen the kind of clips we love. Send them to Free Post, You've Been Framed. And there's 250 quid for every one we show. That's all from me. Cheerio.
Don't turn over. It's TV Burp next, and it's a good one. We've got Shirley off EastEnders Magic Boots, a new system for cleaning your teeth, and a singing pig. All on TV Burp, up next.